What is good, Budget Fam? It's your boy Sneakerhead on the Budget, one of the hardest working sneakerheads on YouTube. Go and leave a like, share, and subscribe. It definitely helps the channel because we're doing big things out here and we're trying to grow this channel out. So today, we're actually working on a restoration today. If I sound a little weird, it's because I'm a little bit under the weather, trying to work through it. But we're going to do this restoration on these alternate 89 Air Jordan 4s. There's a few things we're going to have to do to these. We're going to have to re-whiten the midsole. Then we have to fix some of the scrapes. There's definitely some discoloring on here. So there's a lot of work we're going to have to do. And if you definitely like that kind of content, again, leave a like and share. Definitely subscribe. We do a lot of that stuff out here as well as thrifting and other things. So I don't want to talk too long. Let's go ahead and jump into this video and let's get it done. I guess every superhero need his theme music. No one man should have all that power. The clock's ticking, I just count the hours. Stop tripping, I'm tripping off the power.
My haters kinda glad I'm on. Rest in peace to my vagabond. Rapper song, singer, suspended.
Alright y'all, so the first thing I'm gonna do is when they get rid of these laces, we're gonna give this a little deep cleaning. I'm gonna use some rejuvenator, this works best to me. And then I'm also gonna use a magic eraser to kind of get rid of some of the tough spots. After we get rid of this deep cleaning, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and use some Salon Care 40. And we're gonna use it on the sides right here, this midsole, so we gotta whiten those up a little bit. And I might do it on the bottom a little bit, just kind of lift this, some of that dirt up on there as well. We also gotta get rid of some of the scratches on here. As you can see, the scratches are kind of really bad, so we're gonna try to work through that. But all in all, this shoe definitely needs a deep cleaning, and that's what we're gonna start off first. So let's get to it. So as you see already, we already got rid of a lot of the dirt. As you see, it looks way better now than what it did before. As I can even just put the comparison in, as you see, it looks cleaner. A lot of the dirt that's still on this side, you can actually see a lot of it's gone. So we can go ahead and so after we get finished doing the other one, again, we're gonna go ahead and re-whiten that midsole. I'm gonna paint over some of the little spots that we have so we can get these fixed up. Again, as you see, that cleaned up quite nicely. And everything else here is just gonna be a quick fix. So we're still on our way, still got some work to do, but we're starting off kind of strong here, so let's keep going. All right, Budget Fam, so I'm still a little under the weather, so if you can hear it, you probably can hear it. But we went ahead and cleaned the shoe, and as you can see, the shoe looks really good. I put a towel inside, especially when it dries from the moisture of the material. So it definitely helps with the shaping. We can definitely put a towel in the iron on the top to kind of get rid of the creasing. But when you do that, when it's a little wet, it kind of helps with the shaping. So the shaping's a little better. As you see, the shoe is more wider than usual. There's still some paint we're going to have to redo. But the next step is getting rid of this the yellowing on the midsole. Now, we're going to get rid of these parts right here. I was going to do the bottom, but then I realized, you know, it's going to get stepped on. So it don't need to waste material on that. And we're just going to go ahead and get started. So to use this, use my regular brush. We got some Saran Wrap, got some Salon Care 40, and I have a setup. I'm gonna show you guys my setup in a little bit. So, sorry about that. Ooh.
Damn!
So, we're gonna get started on that, and let's go.
Thank you.
Normally when it comes to getting rid of oxidation, rewhitening shoes, or getting rid of the yellowing, you can use an outdoor setup. And usually I use an outdoor setup, but the only problem is, where I'm from, when the sun's out, it's too hot. So that's, you get a real bad separation. And then when there's no sun, there's no sun. And so that became a real problem with consistency. And so I got my own indoor setup, and I'm going to show you my indoor setup right now. So pretty much right now, this is my indoor setup. I just use like a little cooler, and it has some foil, and I have a towel underneath. If you guys want me to do a separate video to kind of show you the setup and what I got and all the specs and everything, I can definitely do that for you. Just let me know in the comments if you guys want a little tutorial on how to set this up. But I have the foil here for the UV rays, and then I have this Bloom Spectre, which is really good. I believe it is 1,000 UV rays. It could be more. I definitely have to double check it, but I know this one's like the higher end one. And so this one has the fans everywhere, so I don't have to worry about it overheating. And then usually I just turn that bad boy on, and then we got our UV rays hitting it. So they're gonna bounce off the foil, hit on that, and they're gonna rewhiten that for me. Usually what I do as well is to make sure no light escapes fully. I put a piece of foil, I'm trying to do it one-handed. I kind of put like a little piece of foil to kind of block the rays from coming out on the edge right here. While I clean that up, you guys will see what it looks like when it's doing. See, what some people do is they block off the sides because they don't want any UV light coming out. I leave it on because there's fans on the side right there, if you can see it. There's a fan right here and there's a fan right here. I don't want those fans to have full capacity to blow out so it doesn't overheat. Kind of like when you do like your PC gamings or your gaming system at all. You don't want it to overheat. So I give it that breathing room so it can kind of freely flow out and flow around. But as you see in there, you kind of see the shoes are in there right there. I'm getting a good view for you. The shoes are in there right there and they're getting their full setup. I love the way that this thing just cleared up. You see the full setup right there, and you can see how they look a little afterwards. It's safe to leave this in overnight, especially when you have the fan out. Sorry y'all, so I'm gonna leave this in overnight and we're gonna see our funnest project tomorrow. All right, so guys, now it's another day. Now let's go ahead and check on these. All right, let's go ahead and turn this bad boy off, turn this light on a little bit so we can see the action. Because we're about that action, boss. Go ahead and pull these out. And bam. You see that? Yes, sir. I know y'all see that. Look at that yellow lift off. Look at that yellow lift off. About that action, boss.
Really? I'm just about that action, boss.
All right, bunch of fam. So we're next to the next step. So now we have these little white spots we got to repaint and fix. There's some little areas everywhere, so we're just gonna be cleaning that. As you see, the yellowing from the side is gone, and you see the shoe looks pretty much done. So we're just gonna go ahead and repaint that. After that, we're gonna relace these, and then one of these has to be reglued. So I just wanna do everything first, and then we'll do the reglue, then we'll spray it afterwards. So with that, goddamn mosquitoes. Oh, my pants too. Let's get into it. So what we're gonna use is some acetone to cut up some of that paint. Some Angelus flat white, link in the description for anything Angelus wise. Aside from that, let's get to it. Alright y'all, so you see we're able to actually paint over those scuff marks, if you can see it right there. There you go. Paint over some of those scuff marks we had all over the shoe. We're going to hit it with the matte finish. Just the matte finish. Yeah, we're going to hit it with, I'm drawing a blank. We're going to hit it with the matte finish. I'm going to do it outside, since it's only me, there won't be, you can't see me spraying it, but just know I'm going to spray it on there. Then after that, we're going to work on the repaint to get get this midsole put back on, and then after that we are done with these things, y'all. Let's get to it. So I know usually the finishing touch is to put the laces in, but I'm gonna go ahead and put the laces in because this one's pretty much done. Paint dry, everything. This one's pretty much done, and then this one needs to be the reglue. So I'm gonna just put the laces in because I'm already here, and then I'm gonna do the reglue for this one, which is only just
My life be like, ooh, yeah, ooh, my life be like.